In this Cricut tutorial, I am showing you how to make a vertical porch sign just in time for spring and summer with the help of your Cricut cutting machine. So let's get crafty. Hey, I'm Michael from the Mr. Crafty Pants YouTube channel, where I show you crafty tips, tricks, and tutorials every single week. And today I'm over here on the Design Bundles YouTube channel because we have partnered up to bring you all another Cricut tutorial. So make sure that you're watching all the way up until the very end of today's episode because y'all do not want to miss out on a single crafty minute. Now you guys, I just did a video over on my channel that showed you how to DIY your own welcome mat or doormat with the help of your Cricut cutting machine. So today over here on the Design Bundles YouTube channel, I'm showing you all how to make a vertical porch sign to match it, also with the help of your Cricut cutting machine. And to make all this happen, we are obviously going to need a few supplies, including StarCraft HD permanent adhesive vinyl. This stuff is like my go-to. I'm obsessed with it. All of the colors come in both glossy and matte finishes. It's super affordable and the quality is like way, way up there. I'm just obsessed all the way around. We're also gonna need some transfer tape, and I am also obsessed with this. This is the clear medium tech transfer tape. This is also from 143 Vinyl, and I'm honestly just in love with this stuff. I've tried so many different types of transfer tape, and this is honestly the best. I love it. We're also gonna need a sign, right? And I'm using this sign right here. I actually got this on clearance from Joann's, and this is gonna work out really, really great for today's project. I'm also gonna be using some parchment paper, which if you don't know why I'll be using this, your mind is about to be blown when you see what this can do for your Cricut game. It's just amazing all the way around. And last but definitely not least, we're also gonna need an SVG cut file. So let's hop over to designbundles.net and I'll show you the one that I'm using. All right, so this is the file that we're using right here. You actually get a bundle of 8 SVG cut files with this, which is such a remarkable deal. However, we will be using this file right here. And also, let me just point out really, really quick that the pricing on this is insanely good. You get all 8 of these SVG cut files for what was $5, it is now marked down to $3. I can't make any promises of what that price will be by the time that you watch this and go check it out yourself, but that $3 price tag or even the $5 price tag is amazing for all 8 of those SVG cut files. So let's hop over now to Cricut Design Space and let's get started. All right, so as you can see here, I already had this downloaded from designbundles.net and uploaded into Cricut Design Space. And the first thing I'm wanting to do is come over here to the top right-hand side of the page and click on Ungroup. All right, so if you'll notice right here, there is 2 different groupings of the petals for the sunflower. There's a lighter yellow and then like a darker yellow. So what I'm actually wanting to do is combine those because I want just one single solid color for the petals. You can obviously do whatever you want with your sign, but I'm wanting to select this and then holding down my shift key, come down here and select the other layer right here. And then I'm gonna come down here towards the bottom right hand side of the page and click on weld. And weld basically transforms all those layers into just one single solid layer. Now let's take a look really quick at this grouping right here. I'm actually going to come up here towards the top right hand side of the page and click on ungroup for that as well. And for this grouping, obviously this is for home and it's kind of on different layers. Let's go ahead and fix that real quick by coming down here towards the bottom right hand side of the page and clicking on weld. And there we go. So now let's take a look at the actual sign itself. It's obviously a little bit too big for our screen. So let's come over here to the bottom left-hand side of the page and just zoom out a little bit. All right, so that should do the trick for us. And now let's take a look at all the layers. So obviously if you take a look over here in the layers panel, these are all on different layers. So let's go ahead and ungroup this real quick by coming up here and selecting ungroup. All right, so now let's actually go about resizing this to actually fit onto our vertical porch sign. So to do that, I'm gonna come over here to the left-hand side of the page and click on shapes and open up a square. And I'm actually gonna change the dimensions of this to be the exact dimensions of our vertical porch sign. But real quick, let me change the color of this. I know the color does not amount to a hill of beans, but if we come up here towards the top left-hand side of the page, we can click on this little color swatch and let's just change this to white. And this can kind of give you an idea of what your end project will look like if you actually change this to be the color of the surface you're applying it to. So let's come up here towards the top of the page again to where it says size. And the first thing I'm wanting to do is actually unlock this little padlock right here because, well, that padlock locks in the proportions where we can't change the width without it automatically changing the height as well. And we obviously want a different measurement for the width versus the height. So let's unlock the little padlock. And then in here for width, I'm gonna type in here 7.75. because that is the dimensions of the inner portion of our vertical porch sign. And we can go ahead and just hit enter. And then for the height, let's put in here 29.75, since that is the length of our vertical porch sign. Hit enter, and it looks like this is just a little bit too big for our screen yet again. So let's come down here towards the bottom left-hand side of the page and zoom out a little bit more. And just so we can actually see this a little bit better with our white background, let's actually change the background color. So let's come down here towards the bottom right-hand side of the page. I'm gonna click on this little white box next to blank canvas. And then I'm gonna come up here towards the top of the canvas right here where it says color. And we can change this to like a gray color, like so. All right, so that works. So now let's come over here where our design is. Click and drag over all of that. And then let's actually right click it and then select send to front. And then just drag this right over top of our vertical sign. And now what we can do is actually click on this little recess handle right here at the bottom right-hand side of our design. And then just drag this outwards like so. And we basically just make this however big we want it to be on our actual vertical porch sign because, well, this template is the exact same dimensions as our real life vertical porch sign. However, our design looks like on here is what it's going to look like in real life. However, I do think that that is looking pretty good. So we really don't need our template anymore. So let's go ahead and click on that and then click on this little red X up here. And now what I'm wanting to do is actually create a template for our cutting mat. Now today I am using a 12-inch by 12-inch cutting mat, and the maximum cut size for this is 11.5 inches by 11.5 inches. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna create a template of 11.5 inches by 11.5 inches. And we're gonna do that by coming over here again to the side of the page, the left-hand side of the page, clicking on shapes and opening up a square. Now again, the color of this does not amount to a hill of beans, but so many of you all have told me that actually doing the color changes help you all visualize it just a little bit better. So as long as it's helping y'all, I am totally game for doing that. So let's come up here to the top left-hand side of the page, click on this little color swatch, and then just change this to green, just to resemble our green cutting mat. All right, so now let's just change the size of this. So let's come up here where it says size, and right here next to width, I'm gonna type in here 11.5. Now notice this time I did not unlock that padlock, so it kept in the same proportions and it automatically changed the height to be 11.5 inches as well, which is perfect. All right, so let's actually make a couple of these. I'm gonna right click it and then select duplicate, or you could just copy and paste it with Control C, Control V if you're on a PC, or Command C, Command V if you're on a Mac. And let's just see how many of these letters we can fit onto one of these mats. So let me just right click this mat, select send to back. Let's do the same thing for the other mat. And we can just basically slide this behind our designs like so. All right, so we can definitely fit this WEL onto one of these mats. So what I'm gonna do is actually come over here to the right-hand side of the page, click on this little grouping of letters, and then come up here and select ungroup. And what I'm actually wanting to do is click and drag over this WEL, because again, this will fit onto one of these mats. And I'm gonna come down here towards the bottom right-hand side of the page and click on weld. All right, so let's take another really quick look down here and see what all we can fit. So if we try to get the C in here, obviously the center of the sunflower is not gonna be cut out onto this mat because it's a brown color. What we're actually gonna do is put this M, E, and the home all on one of these mats as well. So what I'm gonna do is click and drag over the home and over the M and E. And let's come down here towards the bottom right-hand side of the page and click on weld. And the C might be just a little bit of a straggler. We might have to cut that out separately, but we'll just have to wait and see. No pun intended, I promise. All right, so what I'm gonna do now is come over here and actually delete out these templates. We don't need these anymore. And now let's come up here towards the top right-hand side of the page and click on make it. All right, so Cricut Design Space has automatically laid out our mats where we can actually get the most cuts onto one of the mats. So it automatically combined this M and the E and the home and this WEL. And then on this other mat, we have our little straggler C, which is all right. And then we have the center portion of our sunflower and then the actual petals of our sunflower. But what I'm gonna do is come down here and select continue. All right, so this is the base material cut settings page where we basically pick out the type of material that we're wanting to cut with our Cricut. So what I'm gonna do is come over here and select browse all materials. Since I am using the StarCraft HD permanent adhesive vinyl, my favorite setting for that is the premium vinyl. Some people also use vinyl, but premium vinyl seems to work out better for me personally. But if you are using a Cricut Explore device, just make sure you turn your dial over to custom and then you should have the same option right here. But I'm gonna select browse all materials and then do a search for premium. And then just select premium vinyl, and then come down here towards the bottom right-hand side of the page and click on done. And now all we have to do is load our vinyl onto our mats and get started cutting. All right, so our first mat is done cutting, so I'm gonna go ahead and unload that. And then whenever I'm actually removing any of my vinyl or materials from my cutting mats, what I always like to do is actually flip the mat over and then peel the mat away from the material. And whenever I'm actually weeding this out, I'll actually be using my favorite weeding tool that is currently on the market, which is this pin weeding tool right here. This is such an amazing tool. I'm just obsessed. All right, so we have everything all weeded out, and so now I'm just grabbing my transfer tape and then peeling some of this off with the sticky side facing up towards me. And I'm gonna go ahead and grab one of our pieces, probably the largest of the pieces, which is this one right here. And I'm gonna lay this face first down onto the transfer tape. And then I'm gonna go ahead and grab my scissors and then trim this off. And then I'm gonna grab my squeegee tool and then just burnish this down to the transfer tape. All right, so now I'm gonna go ahead and peel the backing paper off of the vinyl and the transfer tape. All right, so now I'm grabbing my parchment paper, and this is where the magic comes in. I'm just obsessed with this all the way around. I'm gonna take this and apply this down to my vinyl and to my transfer tape. I'm gonna leave a small little portion of the vinyl peeking out above the parchment paper, just like this right here. You can see just a little bit of that vinyl peeking out above the parchment paper. Now, whenever it comes to actually applying vinyl to wood, you really want to make sure that you apply a really good sealant like a polyurethane or a polycrylic to the wood before you apply your vinyl to it. I see the question asked all the time in a bunch of different groups if you should actually apply a sealant over top of vinyl once it's been applied to wood. And the answer to that is no. Like a high quality permanent vinyl like StarCraft HD, this stuff will last outdoors for up to like 5 to 6 years. This is going to do just fine in all the elements. However, what you do need to worry about is the adhesion of the vinyl to the wood. And wood is pretty porous, obviously, so that's why we need to actually go over it with a polycrylic or a polyurethane just to seal it really good and give us like a nice, smooth, clean finish for our vinyl to adhere to. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and line this up wherever I want it to be onto our wooden vertical porch sign. And this parchment paper is basically acting as a barrier between our vinyl and our surface. That way it's not going to prematurely stick down to our surface and then us be stuck with that. So let's go ahead and line this up wherever we want it to be. All right, so once you think you have it laid out wherever you want it, you can go ahead and lay down the top part of that vinyl onto the surface. You can even grab your little squeegee tool and kind of burnish that down like so. And then what you can actually do is actually lift up on the transfer tape, pull out the parchment paper, and then grab your little squeegee tool and then just burnish this down to the surface. All right, so that's down there really good. So let's go ahead and grab a corner of this transfer tape and then peel this back slowly and at an angle. Now, another thing that I absolutely love about this transfer tape is that you can use this stuff over and over and over again. I've used this stuff over 10 times on a single project and I just love it so freaking much. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and repeat that exact same process for the other elements. I'm gonna go ahead and grab our WEL right here and then apply this face first down onto the transfer tape. I'm gonna go ahead and grab my little squeegee tool and then just kind of burnish that down and then peel off the backing paper. Now I'm grabbing that same sheet of parchment paper and then laying this down onto the vinyl and onto the transfer tape. Again, you want to leave a little small portion of that vinyl peeking out above that parchment paper. Now you can go ahead and just line this up wherever you want it to be onto your actual sign. All right, so once you have it wherever you want it to go ahead and grab your little squeegee tool, burnish down the top part of that, lift up the transfer tape, pull out the parchment paper, and then go ahead and grab your squeegee tool again and then just slide this down with your vinyl. Burnish that down really good. And then peel off the transfer tape again pretty slowly and at a sharp angle. All right, so same thing again with this little lonesome C right here. Now, if you all liked today's episode, or if you learned something new, it would honestly mean the world to us and help us out so much here on YouTube if you took just 2 seconds to stamp that like button, as well as drop a comment down in the comment section below. Also, while you're at it, if you are new around here to the Design Bundles YouTube channel, well then you may want to consider stamping that subscribe button and ringing that little bell for all the notifications, because they put out new crafty content literally just about every single day, and you all do not want to miss out on a single crafty minute. I promise you that. Thank you all so much for watching today's episode. It truly does mean the absolute world to me. And until next time, stay crafty.